Irritable bowel syndrome, otherwise known as IBS, is a common condition causing chronic abdominal pain and bowel symptoms. In this video, we will distinguish between IBS and inflammatory bowel diseases such as Crohn's and ulcerative colitis. We will also identify common symptoms of IBS as well as potential risk factors. Irritable bowel syndrome is not a disease. It is a syndrome, meaning a group of symptoms. The symptoms may be very similar to inflammatory bowel disease, or IBD. With IBS, there are symptoms with no structural changes or apparent disease of the intestines. IBS is much more common and is less serious than inflammatory bowel diseases, which can cause severe malnutrition. IBS is not life-threatening and is easier to treat than IBD. It is estimated that more than 21 million Americans suffer from some degree of IBS. The most common symptoms of IBS are abdominal pain and bloating. There is also some form of either constipation or diarrhea, or maybe even a combination of both. Symptoms are likely to get worse after eating, especially with certain foods. There are many changes in the appearance of stools, and mucus is often present. The person may have an incomplete feeling of defecation after going to the bathroom, although for some, their symptoms will greatly improve after going. For women, symptoms may get worse around their menstrual cycle. There are different types of IBS, which are identified based on the frequency of bowel movements. There can be IBS with constipation, IBS with diarrhea, or even IBS with alternating bouts of constipation and diarrhea. Sometimes there is both constipation and diarrhea in the same bowel movement. With IBS, there is no normalcy or consistency with bowel habits. In many cases, the cause of IBS is unknown. There are many different factors that may increase the risk of IBS, however, such as inflammation, impairment of brain and gut signals, food sensitivities and intolerances, infections from bacteria, parasites, or yeast, impaired digestion and absorption, mercury toxicity, and leaky gut. Autoimmune conditions and other health problems, such as liver disease, can increase the risk, as can family history of the condition. In addition to the chemical and biological stressors mentioned, psychological stress will definitely aggravate IBS symptoms. So stress management is an important part of the therapy. Stress can affect your digestion, and people with IBS react far more strongly to emotional triggers such as anxiety and stress. Approximately 50% of those suffering with IBS are also diagnosed with anxiety disorders. Because the symptoms of IBS may be very general, a person may often suffer for years before they see a doctor to be diagnosed. Only about 30% of those with IBS ever consult a doctor, most likely due to the embarrassment of bowel symptoms. It is estimated that about 10 to 15% of the population will be affected by IBS during their lifetime, with women being more often diagnosed than men. IBS is one of the most frequently diagnosed health conditions. Some experts believe that IBS is actually overdiagnosed, and the person may be suffering from other forms of digestive disorders. The good news is that IBS is likely to get better with age. Luckily, there are many ways to manage the symptoms of IBS. The first step is identifying what may be triggering IBS and then fixing those issues if possible. Note that many of the triggers are related to diet. Nutrition plays a large role in alleviating symptoms. As you consider the causes and symptoms of IBS, use your course resources to identify the best diet strategies. What changes would the average American have to make to their diet to help symptoms? How will those changes affect grocery shopping and food preparation?